warmed up, and there wasn't enough heat to get my body warmed up. So I'm glad there was praise, because praise kicked on the fire inside. Amen. Amen. So if you love Jesus and you know he's been good to you and you know God's been faithful, it's time to worship the Lord in our giving. Come on up here, Chris Wilgemuth. Can you guys put your hands together for Chris? God bless you, Chris.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Praise you, Jesus. To God be the glory. When I heard talking about the Father this morning, I remember when my daughter was about 5 years old, and she said, "Dad, I got a new father." It's like, "No, you don't." And she said, "Yes, I do." And I was just like, "What did you learn in Sunday school?" And she goes, "I got a father in heaven." And I was like, "Okay, you can replace him with me any day." And I was like, "You can have him." But it was just neat how she came to realize that she had another dad. And it was a blessing to know that, hey, you can have him replace me any day of the year. And I will allow that because he's a good, good dad. And one of the things I was reading the other day ago was that how many scriptures talk about giving and receiving and giving and receiving and sowing. And we have such good soil in this church. And as not saying as Pastor David would say, but if you don't believe that, you can look at the pastors as a testimony. And as sometimes they say, as the leaders are blessed, the blessings flow downward and the blessings flow from the pastor. So if you want a blessing, you bless where you're being fed. You bless the pastors, you bless the ministry, you bless the church, and those blessings will flow down. So you say, as Pastor David's blessed, I'm blessed. Because he has more than enough, and he gets to give a lot. And I heard a man once tell me, he said, "Chris, trust me on this principle. The more you will receive, the more you'll be able to give, but the more it'll just flow." And I'm sure David and Tracy can attest to that as a testimony, because they don't hoard, they don't, you know, consume things. Everything they receive, as Pastor David says, they just give out. So we want to be like our pastors. We want to be like Jesus did. He was the biggest giver of all. He gave it all. So a lot of times I always feel like God's always challenging me. You have more to give. You have more to give. And I was like, finances? And sometimes he'll say, no, you have other things to give. You have your labor. You have everything. But don't look to man to always receive back. Look to God. And I've made that mistake too many times where I look, oh, come on, man. I gave Pastor David a 10 spot. You know, I want it back, you know. And the Lord says, I'm not giving it back to you through him. And I was like, well, why not? I gave him 10 bucks, man. And the Lord will say, are you trusting in me or are you trusting in man? And we don't want to trust in man. We want to trust in God. And I still believe from the bottom of my heart, even as I was praying this morning in the prayer, that this church is going to be a financial blessing place, that people will literally come in here and get blessed financially, and everyone in here will have so much to give. They'll be praying, Lord, where can I sow? Where can I give? Because we are blessed and we are the head and not the tail. And that's one of the things that I felt strongly to pray, and that if you believe it, you receive it. If you can see it, you can have it. So just thank God for whatever you need. The simplicity of faith to me is whatever you thank God for as a little child and you believe you've received it, I don't care what it is. It could be a Cadillac. God's going to give it to you because as we're learning about such a good, good dad, he loves his children. He wants to bless his children. So if you believe, you'll receive. I'm going to read something about trusting God or trusting self. In Hosea, you can turn to verse 10, 12, and 13. And Hosea, you sow to yourselves in righteousness, you reap in mercy. Break up your fallow ground, for it is time to seek the Lord till he come and rain righteousness upon you. You have plowed wickedness, you have reaped iniquity, you have eaten the fruit of lies, because thou didst trust in thy way in the multitude of the mighty men. Sow for yourselves, this is another version, sow for yourself righteousness, reap the fruit of unfailing love, and break up your unplowed ground. For it is time to seek the Lord until he comes and showers righteousness on you. But you have planted wickedness. You have reaped evil. You have eaten the fruit of deception because you have depended on your own strength and on your many warriors. That was in the NIV. So again, it gets into the point of trusting God or trusting self and trusting warriors. If you're trusting God, you're going to receive God's reward. And we've all sown things financially in other areas in our life, and sometimes we have to look to God. And if you sow financially, obviously God's going to reap financially. But I still believe, according to this word and many other words, that if you sow righteousness, if you sow unto God with your finances and aim that seed at a particular promise that God has in his word, God's going to provide it for you. So stand up, and we're going to say some brief and amazing confessions there. One of the things a lot of people ask me, well, where is the decreeing in the Bible? And you can look at Job 22:28. It says, decree a thing, and it will be established. So that's God's word. It's not something that I'm just doing to quote the word of God. It's something God said to do. I'm just going to go off what I know in my heart. I can't find my exact page that I was going to go off. Father God, we thank you that we know according to your word, what we sow will reap. We sow big and we reap big. We thank you, Father, in Jesus' name, as we purpose in our heart to give unto you, we give her all, and we thank you, Lord, for reaping 30, 60, 100-fold in Jesus' name. Come worship the Lord in your giving.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never. Good Father, it's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you, it's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know
All right. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. You are a good Father. You don't ask us for our finances because you have ill intent, but because you know what's best for us. You have no need of anything from this earth, but the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. And Lord, humbly we say this year, Lord, is going to be our finest hour of knowing you, seeing you, watching you in all of our life expand our horizons, our territory, our influence. Because we say yes, because we go lower, because we choose the humble path of the Master. And so, God, we give, and it shall be given to us. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give unto our bosoms. We thank you, Father, for the it is you that gives us the power to get wealth and establish your covenant in the earth. And so, Father, for all the people in this room, we lift this up as one body and we say, thank you, Father. We say, thank you, Lord. We lift up our fishes. We lift up our loaves. And we look around and we see 5,000 and we say, it's not enough to feed a multitude. But we know when we trust in our God. We know when we trust in the Lord with all of our hearts and we lean not on our own understanding. In all of our ways, we acknowledge you. You direct our path, Lord. You break open those fish. You break open those loaves. You feed multitudes out of my insignificance. You make significance, God. And I thank you, Lord, that it's because we've been able to make history together, you and I, and us together as a body, God. We've been able to watch you be faithful. And we thank you, God. We thank you, God, that you never leave us nor forsake us. You never let us alone, God, but you're always doing things for our best interest. And for that, we say thank you. It's our pleasure to partner with heaven. Amen. And we thank you, Lord, for blessing your people, Lord. Let increase come swiftly on their behalf, breakthroughs and supernatural increase. In Jesus' name, we thank you. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Is that awesome, guys? Bless the Lord. Come on. It's really good to trust in the Lord, you know. And if you've always been skeptical of finances, finances will be skeptical of you. All right, y'all ain't ready for me. Come on, Tracy. You look nice too. Anyway.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so I'm just going to run through the announcements really fast. I'm excited about the Word of God today. I have a little bit of an idea of what it's won this time. So house church, Monday night with Darlene and Roy. Woo, woo, if you've never gone and you're interested in going, please lift your hand, Darlene. You guys can come and ask Darlene how to get there, or if you need rides, you know, she can help coordinate through me and through the people that pick people up. Training for Reigning is Tuesday at 7 p.m. We start, we break down in our classes. If you are not sure what those classes are, it is on Facebook. There's pictures of the group and the titles of the class. Wednesday is our leadership meeting at 7 p.m. We will be having our leadership meeting. I know this week is a packed week. Just say, I'm going to be on fire for God all week.
I'm going to be on fire for God
all
week.
Let's try it together. I'm going to be on fire for God all week. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Oh, my gosh. Do you know what's going to happen? Something's going to happen. And for each of us, it's going to be different, but it's going to be good. You put him first like that, and I'm not saying, I understand people have jobs, I understand people have families, but listen, they have crock pots. Have you ever heard of crock pots? I get this, I got to cook dinner. Well, I understand we got to cook dinner, but what I used to do is I used to hit my crock pot the night before, and everything would be organized and prepared, and I could still eat. So it can work, I promise, if you organize. Yeah, crock pot is a single mom's best friend. I'm not a single mom any longer, but when I was. So New Year, New Glory Conference. I had the House of Levi reached out to Jeremy, And they said that they had this really prophetic dream about this conference, and they actually want to be here, so they're going to be here. I don't know if they got a chance to share that with you or not. So a couple people have had some really strong dreams about this conference, so I'm looking forward. It starts Thursday night, Friday, Saturday, and they will be here as well on Sunday speaking. Any volunteers that are available, can you meet me in the 6 to 9-year-old room? Most of you know, like coffee bar, parking lot, the book table, which Colleen wants to be involved with that, and anybody else, and Chris generally would do the books after service. But there's a children's meeting after service. So if you can help, how about if we do this, that you text me? Is that okay? Just shoot me text messages, and I'm going to respond to you. Because there is a children's meeting today after service. I do not want a conflict with that. Thank you, Matthew. The calendar has all upcoming events. There's a calendar on the Connect table. It gives you the next 3 months. That does not mean that things will not be added, but that is what we have right now for you guys to be aware of. And I have one more announcement, but I wanted to see Jeff for a second. Oh, come here for a second. I got to whisper in his ear for 1 minute before I announce this. So the prayer house starts back up this week, and we're changing the schedule a little bit on the prayer house, but I wanted to submit that first to make sure it was okay. Monday from 10 to 2. Normally it's open Tuesday in the day, but we're not going to do it Tuesday in the day because we have training for reigning in the evening, and then we have night watch prayer on Tuesday evenings because we're kicking that back off. Everyone's really been missing that time of prayer and soaking. So the classes should end very close to 9:15-ish. At 9:30, we will start night watch prayer like we used to do. People just kind of soak and they pray. And I understand that you know, there's things you can stay for, there's things you can't. This is just for whoever can, okay? You talk to Papa about that stuff, okay? And then Wednesday, the prayer house will be open from 10 to 2, but that we are asking that is a man's day. I know that sounds so funny. But the men are going to come out on Wednesday only from 10 to 2 to pray. And honestly, we just had this great conversation with these lovely people about when men really started stepping up and praying in the church, how things really started moving in the spirit, and how the attack, we were talking about how he said 95% of people in jail are men, is what the statistics say. Now, I'm just saying what this conversation was. And the attack is against the men because the men are the fathers. And the hurting that's going on is the fatherless generation. So if the men start stepping back into their positions, things will start shifting in this region. Like you will never, like quicker than you can imagine. And I'm putting a call and a mandate on men. And not just from 10 to 2 on Wednesdays. I'm talking about Monday through Sunday. Amen. So let that Deborah anointing come forth in Jesus' name. So, and then Thursday, the prayer house will be open from 10 to 2. So pretty much Monday and Thursdays, it's open to everybody from 10 to 2. Okay, and that is all my announcements. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we do have the singles Bible study today in between services in the 6 to 9-year-old classroom. That's with Charles. For those that know Charles or want to attend that, he does a pretty deep Bible study. Okay, Pastor David. Oh, children may be released. If they haven't been released already.
All right. Praise God.